In the previous video, I walked you through some of the foundational tools and skills you'll be taking advantage of in your studies with logos. In this video, we're going to build on those skills and equip you to tackle some of the more advanced features you'll want to master. So, let's get started. As you study the Bible, you'll notice that many translations feature superscript sprinkled throughout the text. Each of these represents a cross-reference to another location in your Bible. These cross-references point you to passages that are related to the verse in question. Simply hover over one to view the reference, or click the superscript and then the reference to jump to that location in your open Bible. You can also use the cross-references guide to find all of the labeled cross-references for any passage you enter. To access this tool, click Guides at the top, type Cross in the search box, then click Cross References. From here, all you need to do is enter a Bible reference or passage title and press Enter. The guide will then display verses that are related to what you entered. The first five will show the reference and text, and any others will be listed as hyperlinks to the relevant verses. You can also choose to save your results as a passage list document, or open a filtered view of your preferred Bible comprised of only the listed cross-references. Another Bible study tool in your Logos tool belt is the Parallel Passages Guide. Just like the cross-references guide, you can find this tool in the Guides menu. Click Guides at the top, type Parallel in the search box, then click Parallel Passages. Again, all you need to do is enter a Bible reference or passage title and press Enter. The guide lists passages that cover the same material as the one you entered, such as narrations of the same event in the Synoptic Gospels. The results display article headings that link to relevant resources and the verses it is parallel to. Now that I've shown you how to find other passages connected to the one you're studying, it's time to talk about highlighting and taking notes as you read. With Logos, you can mark up your digital books just like you do with paper books, and there are several different ways to do this. The simplest way is through the selection menu. To access the selection menu, simply click and drag your cursor across any range of text. The selection menu will appear and offer a variety of options to choose from. But for our purposes here, we'll focus on the middle section. Clicking any of the options in the middle applies that highlighting style to your selected text. Note that these options adjust over time since they automatically display your six most used highlighting styles. Click the button on the right to open the highlighting tool, which contains all of the markup styles available to you. Click the button on the left to add a note on your selected text. You can also access these options by right-clicking your selected text to open the context menu, then clicking Take a Note or a highlighting style. In addition to the note-taking and highlighting tools, this menu provides access to a whole host of study tools that are covered in more detail in other videos. Finally, you can also open the Notes tool and Highlighting tool from the Tools menu. One other handy tool that you're sure to get a lot of mileage from is the Information tool. Housed in the Tools menu, information displays in-depth detail about original language words, different translations, figures of speech, preaching themes, and much more. You can choose to set the tool so it updates either when you hover over a word or when you click a word. I prefer to set mine to click, so my results stay in the information pane even when I move my cursor away. But what do you do if you want to study a passage but can't remember where to find it? Look no further than your basic Bible search, which has fuzzy search capabilities built in. This means you can type a biblical phrase to the best of your recollection and Logos will track it down even if the words aren't exactly right. Start by clicking the search icon in the Go box to open a search panel. Click Bible to run a search that is limited to the biblical text, and enter the word or phrase you want to find. Notice that you can search a specific Bible or multiple Bibles by clicking the drop-down at the top. As you're working your way through John 15, perhaps you're reminded of a passage that mentions Christ humbling himself, but that's all you can remember. Simply enter what you remember, like Christ humbled himself, in the search box, and Logos returns results that match your search, including Philippians 2:8, even though the words actually read, "He humbled himself." If at this point you're thinking, wait, I don't even know where to start when it comes to Bible study, then let's turn our attention to workflows. No matter which Logos package you own, it comes with workflows that guide you step by step through your studies. These are great for everyone from novices to experts. Workflows are housed in their own section of the guides menu, so you can start a new one with just a couple of clicks. When you have a workflow underway, you can continue it from the guides menu or from the homepage. So, if you want to take your Bible study deeper, or see how other people study, consider starting a basic Bible study or inductive Bible study workflow. Once you've selected one, just enter the passage you want to study and follow the prompts. It's that easy. While it's great to have several resources open and visible at one time, you may want to focus your attention on just one book, and that's where Reading View comes in. This setting brings one panel to the foreground so you can see just one resource at a time. You can quickly open Reader Mode with keyboard shortcuts like Command-Option-R on a Mac or F11 on Windows. Or you can open the Panel menu and select Show Reading View. With your book filling the whole screen, you may want to display the text in multiple columns. From the panel menu, select how many columns you'd like to see your text in, or choose Auto to have Logos decide on the number of columns that best fits your screen size and display settings. You'll notice that changing to column view also changes the way you navigate your book. Rather than an infinitely scrolling display, scrolling now moves from one page to another. It also adds forward and backward buttons at the bottom of the screen that you can use to navigate one page at a time. Another option that becomes available in column view is one that displays the book's footnotes at the bottom of each column. From the panel menu again, select the option to show footnotes on page and watch as Logos immediately displays the footnotes. Now that you've tested out some of the most commonly used features of Logos, you're ready to dive into your studies. As you continue to use Logos, you'll come across even more powerful and exciting features. And the Logos Help Center is there to answer your questions as they arise. Visit support.logos.com to find articles and videos created to help you get the most out of your Logos Bible software. We hope to see you there.